stretch it all the way
back. Yeah. And then I'm also finding
I thought they took the power strip one over here. Is that
like the power strip?
Oh, okay. We're so handy.
You are confirmed that you have power. Correct?
Yep.
Okay, cool.
It's in theory, yes, but they didn't really get them. Because the auditions part were like joint auditions for the other children, so they're doing both. And like most of the kids that auditioned were tiny, so they just probably one of my good friends, and she's the same one that's directing all the bands, so we'll be. No, she doesn't really have auditions, she kind of just like calls up people that she likes. No,
she's got her dad.
That's Hamlet.
Test 1, 2, 1, 2. What? Two? Two. Two. Test. One, two, two.
Thank you. Welcome to the graduation ceremony for the class of 2023. Congratulations to these seniors and a special thank you to all the families for the support. Please stand if you are able for the singing of our national anthem by our honors chorus class and interpreted by our honors American Sign Language class. Would those folks please come forward? The flag is to your right, beyond the south end zone.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the
good afternoon, Nauset families, faculty and staff, honored guests, Drs. Clenchy and Millen, and most importantly, graduates, this great class of 2023. Welcome to commencement, the formal ceremonial proclamation that you are continuing on your journey, ready to engage the world in new, adventurous, and fulfilling ways. Here you sit at life's trailhead, ready to take the next step forward. And before you hit the trail, today we take a pause and an inventory. By engaging in learning and in life during your days at Nauset, you are trained, provisioned, and oriented for success on the trail of life. Rest assured that your boots are double knotted, your pack is organized, and your skills to navigate, think, adjust, and discern are honed. So for today, just a couple of recommendations for a successful journey forward. There will be days on the trail of bright sunlight, cool breezes, when the earth spins gently beneath your feet, and all seems just right with the world. Your fitness, your wellness, your spirit in effortless harmony propelling you forward in a state of flow where you and your task are completely intertwined. There'll be other days when the winds howl and you struggle to find your footing and you honestly wonder whether you can keep moving forward. Please know you can always keep moving forward. The difficult slogging days are when you learn what you are truly made of. Those days are necessary to understand the joys of crossing that finish line or reaching that mountaintop. The slog is a gift to embrace. Always avoid a meek effort or mild decisions like those of President McKinley when Teddy Roosevelt told him, "You, my friend, have the spine of a chocolate eclair." On the trail of life, you'll need a spine much greater than that of a pastry. Along the journey, you will encounter fellow travelers who could use some encouragement, some provisions, or guidance to keep moving forward. Take the time to listen, share, and support, as the trail is not always a race, and engaging in the journey is always a victory. Never underestimate your power to create a breakthrough moment for another, a clarity, a purpose, making someone push on. And after you give, you will understand that it was you doing the receiving. Always travel light. On the trail, you don't want to weigh yourself down with unnecessary material. Great minds like Socrates, Mother Teresa, and Eddie Vedder all warned against the materialistic pursuits. I recommend that you avoid becoming one of those people who does work they don't love to buy stuff they don't need to impress people they wish would go away. On the trail of life, it doesn't much matter if you have a happy, smiling blue whale, a dunking Air Jordan, or a malleted lad on horseback adorning your shirt pocket. What does matter is that you carry an extra $2.32 in case a struggling neighbor could use a medium regular. Choose your travel partner wisely. A partner who will encourage, support, and challenge you, raise you up to become the best version of yourself every day. A partner who will help you maximize your potential while avoiding obstacles and distractions. A partner who will help you identify and slay dragons that might lurk in the darkness. When you encounter nefarious creatures, take them on directly, without hesitation or avoidance, because as the ancient Romans taught us, the obstacle becomes the way, the only meaningful way to move forward with focus and with purpose. So here you sit, graduates, ready to move forward, positioned for success with your next first step. Your tools of self-management and self-discipline will be your guide. Your durability, provisioning, and training have you ready to cross your next finish line, reach your next mountaintop, and then further down the trail, any goal of your choosing. So today I implore you to take the advice of the great Olympian Steve Prefontaine, and get after it with all that you are made of, because anything less is to sell yourself short and to sacrifice your gifts. Maximize potential, the absolute best you are capable of. That's the metric, the only metric to measure yourself against on the trail of life. And always, always, always keep moving forward. So that's it, my young friends. Each in your own way. Head off, hit the trail, and have a Nauset day. And now on to the important people. It is my privilege to introduce Sophia Easley to give the class president address.
All right. Hello, everyone. How are you all doing today? All right. Okay. I would like to begin by welcoming Superintendent Clenchy, Director Millen, Principal Clark, Assistant Principal McGrath, Assistant Principal Ewan, our incredible faculty, parents, friends, and of course, the class of 2023 for being here today. And a special shout out to our amazing class advisors, Ms. Hepp and Ms. Kimmick, for their incredible spirit and support over these past 4 years. They're incredible. Okay, today is a day filled with excitement and many emotions. We have become who we are today thanks to our best friends right beside us, the greater class surrounding us, and the family and friends in the audience who sit before us. With these people in this place for this occasion, we realize that there is a lot to be grateful for. Today, I want to remember our high school experience together. Just after the days of middle school when we were snowballing at Rock Night and holding hands at the Sparrow, emerging from those awkward times, we were sent off to high school with no clue how to act and totally unsure of the people we were hoping to become. We started freshman year off strong in September 2019, welcomed by Dr. Elsasser's speeches about turning left and taking the road less traveled. For our first spirit week, dressed in white, we brought the energy, although we may have made some senior enemies along the way for passing out headbands. Let us say that they were not ready for the freshman class competition they got. School had become increasingly more difficult, such as Ms. Tringali's physics class, where we calculated the time it took for a ball to hit the ground, and somehow we would always come up with a negative number. Or at least I did. Then, As we headed into spring, we sadly had to say goodbye to each other when Friday the 13th hit, the beginning of COVID, and what we thought would be a two-week break. Sophomore year, we met our teachers and reunited with our friends over Zoom, and eventually made our way to hybrid learning. Mass breaks became the highlight of our days. During those 10 minutes of fresh air, we would make the most of doing the Wordle, playing Frisbee, or taking Miss Legacy on in plank or push-up competitions, where Ella Woods was probably the only one who ever stood a chance. We also had some impressive sports accomplishments, even though all-state tournaments were canceled. Boys soccer had a perfect record, only conceding 2 goals, and according to Arlo, could have won states if we're given the chance. Junior year, we were back and all in person, fully masked until it eventually became optional, and we saw new faces for the first time. We were again intimidating the seniors with our school spirit, taking a big win in the Powder Puff game, and showing up for Spirit Week with trash cans as backpacks for our last year as underclassmen. We are also showcasing our immense talent in the arts, as Emma Taylor stole the show with her amazing voice as Belle in Beauty and the Beast. Also, there were some crazy memories from the infamous B Building bathroom that make us all very happy we have such a great custodial staff. Senior year, this was our best year and felt closest to normal. We have proven that we are the class to beat and finally have our time to shine. And as Ms. Hepp says, we have our crowns up and are ready to leave Nauset on a high note. We joined in on the classic tradition, like our senior year prank of the slow and safe boat, which still sits proudly in the courtyard. We did it all together as a highly motivated, tight-knit group who have big dreams for the future. We have made it through it all with our best friends supporting us and making us laugh the entire way. And as we say goodbye today, it feels only right to leave you with a quote. I have chosen a very special message from my favorite story of all time, The Lorax, by Dr. Seuss. It goes, unless someone like you cares a whole awful lot, nothing's going to get better, it's not. As we go off on our own journeys, please remember the importance of everything you do. Just as every single one of us has had a great impact on our class, we will continue to have a significant power to impact all that is around us in the future. Continue to be the unless, the catalyst for change you want to see in the world. You are so much more impactful than you could ever realize. Thank you all for your love and support. And as they say, this is only the beginning, and that could not be more true for our class of 2023. And one more thing. Sorry. Okay, I have a brief announcement on behalf of the class of 2023. Lexi Yell, our incredible vice president and classmate, holds a very special place in our hearts. We want to share our love and support with her. The Yell family tragically and suddenly lost Lexi's older brother, Jackson, a 2020 graduate this spring. On behalf of the class of 2023, we would like to put a Jackson Yell memorial bench overlooking Eldridge Park baseball field. This will serve as a reminder of Jackson's love for baseball, and he can forever watch over our Nauset baseball games. We hope that this can provide a special place to visit, remember, and honor Jackson. All of our love. The Nauset Regional Class of 2023. Thank you.
It is now my privilege to introduce Nick Vole to give the salutatory address.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished faculty members, proud parents, guests, and most importantly, Nauset's class of 2023. We have assembled here today to celebrate a remarkable achievement and milestone in our lives, our graduation. Look, man, it's tough. First and foremost, I want to take a moment to express some overdue gratitude to those who have supported us on our journey. To our families, thank you for your unwavering love, encouragement, and sacrifices. Your support has been the foundation upon which our achievements have been built. To our educators and academic mentors, thank you for your dedication, patience, and guidance. You have nurtured our minds, challenged our intellects, and inspired us to reach for greatness. To our coaches, thank you for demonstrating the power of discipline and perseverance, acting as pillars of strength and drawing out the potential of all Nauset athletes. I'm sure some of our class would claim that our time here flew by. I am not one of those people. It was undeniably difficult, but the only factor pushing us through being the knowledge that someday it would be over. However, amidst those challenges, we grew. We discovered new passions, created communities, inspired art and social change, performed in front of live audiences, won championships, and so much more. We became masters of our environment and adept in adaptation to change. Each and every graduating student has left an indelible mark on Nauset, even knowing that someday we would be forced to move on. Someday, the curtain would close and we would face a void of uncertainty. So, when is that someday? I have a feeling you already know the answer. Regardless, let's rewind again for a moment. Our time here has been nothing short of chaos. Moving from middle school to a high school, to a global pandemic with Zoom, and now a construction zone, as you can see over there. Even so, I can still vividly recall the entirety of one facet of my experience at Nauset High School, my time on the football team, during which I went from breaking my collarbone twice during my freshman year to representing the team as a captain my senior year. I fostered qualities in myself that make me proud of not only who I am, but also the impact that I have had on this school and its occupants. Yeah, with each passing day of this year, I was reminded that we are taking small but tangible steps toward an untouched and unfamiliar world. No moment was this clearer than November 10th, 2022, 2 weeks before Thanksgiving, and my final time playing on the Nauset turf. We had just shut Medfield out 20-0, and we all went around smiling and taking pictures in front of the scoreboard. But when all was quiet and everyone returned to their cars, it was just three of us left on the turf. My two friends, Alex and Deej, and I. We stood there on the 50-yard line, gazing around at the empty bleachers, the blinding lights, the moon flying overhead, giving life to new stars in its wake. Afterward, I changed, packed up my shoulder pads, walked to my car, and for the first time in a while, I cried. Crying does not come easily to me, though I'm sure my mom would beg to differ. I realized what I would imminently lose at that moment, recognizing that someday loomed far closer than I imagined. I'm sure we have all felt moments like this to some degree, knowing that in graduating from high school, we are letting go of a piece of ourselves, passing friendly smiles, small waves across the courtyard, discussions and debates at lunch tables. It feels like it's all slipping away, like sand between our fingers. So instead of leaving behind all that we have gained over these past 4 years, let us bring it with us. We carry the memories and friendships we have built in this place onto the next chapter of our lives as champions of the circumstances that created us and embracing the new with open arms. The echoes of the past are not lost, and instead they are even more valuable to us now. Today is a celebration for the new, not a funeral for the old. The future's bright horizon has never been more visible, and with our experiences strapped upon our backs, the time has come to trek off to it. We will walk on the ground and ensure our tiny planet is vibrant and alive, full of empathy, laughter, and richness. Yet simultaneously, we will soar so high that the Earth becomes but a speck upon the canvas which we will use to paint our own paths, bounding beyond the boundaries of any preconceived notion or limitation, the precipice of infinite possibilities. The time to forge and seize our own destinies awaits. So I implore you all, wake up and face the world, because that someday is right now. Thank you.
Well done. Very, very well done. Good for you.
Good for you.
Now I would like to ask members of our Honors Chorus to come forward to perform Homeward Bound by Mark DeKeen and directed by our chorus teacher, Tom Farris.
Homeward bound again.
And now it is my privilege to introduce Emma Easley to give the valedictorian speech.
Hi, everybody. Although looking out at this huge crowd is pretty scary, it is truly an honor to be able to represent the class of 2023 as we share our celebrated achievement today. We wouldn't be here today if it weren't for the support of our families, friends, and teachers over the past 4 years. So now I would like the class of 2023 to stand and to give a quick round of applause as a token of our gratitude. Thank you, everybody. Okay. For the longest time, I thought that the number 23 placed at the beginning of our school emails, the year in which we would graduate, seemed so far away. There was no way that all that time could pass and that little me would become one of those big, intimidating high school seniors that I had looked up to for so long. However, that reality set in very quickly when the college application, FAFSA, and scholarship deadlines all started arriving in a flash. I'm the type of person who puts off everything until the last minute, and choosing which college I would attend in the fall was no exception. I would love to say that I was calm throughout the process, but that wasn't really the case. On a particularly rough day in late April, when I was still trying to make a decision, I walked into my comparative gov class and heard all of my peers excitedly talking about their chosen colleges and determined future plans. Of course, I was happy for them, but it made me feel a bit stressed. I think our teacher, Mr. Mack, could tell I was feeling overwhelmed by my uncertainty. He came up to me and said something along the lines of, "No matter where you go, I know you will succeed." Not only did this provide me with some much-needed comfort, but it forced me to reflect as well. I realized that growing up on the Cape and within the Nauset District has provided me with all of the tools that I need to be able to thrive as I embark on my future. Part of what made choosing a school so challenging was that it felt like nothing could replace the academic environment that I've been able to experience thus far. Ever since starting preschool at Wellfleet Elementary, the core values of kindness, compassion, and awareness have been deeply rooted in our education and still persist to this day. The sense of community and support within Nauset fosters growth and embraces individuality. In my case, I felt this through the support of my friends, who I was excited to see every lunch and passing time, my family, who made me feel as though I could do no wrong, Ms. Kimmick's constant snack supply, and even when Mr. Andrew Clark would regularly ask me if I was getting enough sleep, when we both knew I probably wasn't. We will hold on to these lessons and values even after we leave Nauset, allowing our memories together to guide us through the rest of our lives. Growth begins at the roots, and our roots are anchored as the class of 2023, which supplies us with the means necessary to branch out individually and take charge of our futures. If you're scared to start your next adventure, or you couldn't be more excited to leave high school, or you fall somewhere in the middle like me, no matter what you do, the lessons you gain growing up here will always support you. We all share at least one huge success in graduating high school, but I know there's more in store for each and every one of us. As a concept, success is both fluid and personal, and I'm sure that our definitions of success will change as we grow, and triumph will present itself in many unexpected ways. It is important that we never compare ourselves to anyone else, as each one of us has different strengths and timelines that make us so unique, because there's not just one right way to live. Just like we've grown up being kind to our community and classmates, it is equally important that we are kind to ourselves. Remember that victory takes hard work, and there will definitely be bumps along the road. But I know that we all have the strength to overcome them. I hope you all find nothing but pride and happiness in the next chapter of your life. So go be great. Thank you.
Now I would like to introduce the combined Nauset Regional High School bands and orchestra who will be performing Jupiter, Bringer of Jollity from The Planets by Gustav Holst, arranged by Vernon Liedig and directed by our own music teacher, Dan Anthony. Now it's my privilege to introduce our superintendent of schools, Dr. Brooke Clenchey.
Good afternoon, and thank you so much. To the graduates, before I start my formal remarks, to those of you who took part yesterday in the senior walkthrough, you have no idea how much that touched the hearts of your elementary and middle school teachers. They were looking so forward to that. And I think at Stony Brook, I don't think there was a dry eye in the house. Thank you so much for that special moment. I'm sure that you felt that love and respect and affection that your community has for you, just as you do today. But an extra special thank you for that. Good afternoon, graduates, distinguished guests, families, administration, and staff. Graduates, today marks a special day, a milestone in your life journey. It is the end of a chapter, as one of you said earlier, and it signals the beginning of something brand new, something exciting, and something unknown. And you are well positioned to write that new chapter that will be unique to only you. And you will control the narrative and write that unique story. You are a class filled with musicians, artists, scholars, athletes, writers, entrepreneurs, innovators, teachers, and learners, and so much more. Your collective potential is limitless. And we will take joy as your families, as we watch you from afar develop new skill sets and new talents and build upon all that you already do so well. As you refine your unique gifts and discover new passions, your story will begin to unfold. And you can expect, exactly as Principal Clark had said, that your personal journey will consist of twists and turns and may well require a few directions. And this is normal. Life is not a linear journey, but every experience will have meaning and it will help to guide you through to your next steps. Life is about those experiences. And the words of Ralph Waldo Emerson, life is about the journey, not the destination. And it is those experiences that we have in life that make us rich. They build our character and they strengthen who we are and they help to define us, they season us. You will adapt and innovate. You will have the stamina and the courage that you need, just as you have had during these last several years. And you will have the necessary perseverance, grit, and resilience. You are the author of these next chapters, and you will be amazing. And as you pursue your passions, do be cautious about the need to achieve perfection. There's nothing wrong with pursuing a perfection, but perfection can sometimes be an unrealistic standard. Striving to be the best that you can be is what you need to ask of yourself. And don't let perfection be the enemy of good. You have grown and accomplished so many things along your high school journey. And today we all take pride in where you have landed as we bask in those accomplishments. And each of those accomplishments have led you here today, successfully earning today's recognition. You have learned so much within the last couple of years beyond a school textbook, and all of it will serve you well. Best wishes as you continue a new and exciting journey, and I am confident that you are all destined to do great and amazing things. Congratulations to the class of 2023. And I know that you know this is not the time to throw the cap, so I just want to put that out there again. By the authority vested in me as the Nauset School District Superintendent, and having been advised of your completion of the requirements prescribed by the Massachusetts Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, I now confirm you the Nauset Regional High School Class of 2023 graduated.
Thank you, Superintendent Clinchy. Now it is my privilege to introduce the head of our school counseling department, Katie Cameron, who will read the names and presenting of the diplomas.
Emma Groden Easley. Alexandra Louise Yell. Molly Sue Coakley. Jillian Elizabeth Parrott. Emma Noelle Byrne. Ella Brooke McGrath. Natalie Ann Fisher. Kelly Lynn Dulac. Josie Jessica Boscus. Sarah Munson Needell. Bailey Elizabeth Kavanaugh. Ella Jane Woods. Sarah Peyton Cornell. Nicholas Lawrence Bull. Alexander William Layton. Jared Hooper. Allison Jane Wigglesworth. Michael Olivier Nass. Rufus Strite McCleary. Lily McGregor Hay. Daisy Thurber O'Neill. David George Sargison. Patrick Thomas O'Keefe. Purva Rohit Patel. Jonathan Olivier Nass. Ashton Daniels. Edison Bailey Bolaris. Declan James Mackinaw. Nathan James Watring. Rafael Agustin Serrano. Joseph Vuvakis. Owen John Flores. Miles James Santos. Raiden Hughes. Nico Reed Harrington. Arlo Lawless. Henry Yardeman Mayu Rank. Delaney Teresa Colton. Jordan Matthew Frant. Lucas Stelios Stagakis. Caden Miles Damore. Christina Tusillo. Hannah Ann Remy. Rosa Sheldon Larkin Warner. Elizabeth Handel. Clara Elizabeth Colley. Leela Hope Bailey. Layla Jane Collum. Lilu Isabella Wisbauer. Primalia Starbuck Cullum. Blakely Arden Serafina Cullum. Ava Elizabeth Sacco. Eliana Grace Magnata Galazzi. Audrey Ruth Merchant. Skylar Lauren Slayson. DiGiorno Alfonso Davis. Logan Daniel Villain. Amanda Grace Payne. Isabel Carolyn Robichaud. Parker Gamzee. Sasha Fettig. Deacon Arcomano. Cameron Seth Shepherd. Jordan Tyler Schular. Carmen Maria Magliozzi. Alexander James Goshen. Brian Zaid James DeMarsh. Joanna Lynn Van Gelder. Jyoti Ann Michaels. Brittany Lynn Ballou. Emma Ann Pasilio. Sabine Marie Crum. Phoebe Carey Lowry. Emily Ann Underhill. Grace Amber Harris. Daniel Thomas Deering. Maxwell Hutton. Corey Joseph Vendetti. Reese Cameron Burge. Alex Christopher Burris. Yeah.
Seamus Richard St. Aubin. Duncan Andrew Lowry. Quinn Muha. Benjamin Taylor Rose. Peyton Kender. McKenna Catherine Kavanaugh. Kaylee Marie Davis. Kerry Ruth Farrell. Jack Alexander Cronin. Ella Marie Squire. Elizabeth Grace Norton. Dylan Joy. Jack Montgomery. Cameron Bradley. Catherine Faye Musso. Sophie Isabel McIsaac. Caitlin Charlotte Bohannon. Jillian McKee Gilmore. Emily Shayna Plansky. Alexander Edward Dutois. Katie Ray Kelleher O'Reilly. Sophia Alice Rose Ryan. Joshua Christopher Chisholm. Om Shrestha. Luke Joseph Leonard. Willow Clark. Paul Nazareno Saliba. Maya Ann Renkainen. Jake Wanamaker. Alexander Milano. Jackson Thomas Dalmau.
Yeah, Jackson!
Christopher Joseph Barber.
Yeah!
Josie Bliss Gaynor. James Connor Pike.
Woo!
Malcolm Mackenzie Stewart. Aurelia Sky Pabo. Juniper Lee O'Campbell. Grace May Curtis. Katrina Bryn Hatch. Nora Ann McCutcheon. Sienna Sky Azure. Kimberly Ann Savory. Lucy Carol Swain. Thomas James Johnson. Joshua Brian Bodmer. Emily Elizabeth Kissa. Autumn May Howes. Savannah Ann Still. Dylan Gregory Bruckner. Kaylin Marie Potter. Ava Mae White Pasquale. Alyssa Jean Silva. Yeah. Taylor J. Pierce. Raven Arrow Mark Bennett. Ryan John Pasilio. Cecilia Pearl Labarge. Ava Irene Doyle. Mia Rose Stafford. Maya Isabella Gonzalez Whipple. Amelia Michelle Stevens. Alden Elizabeth Rogers. Kylie Reagan Doherty. Ashlyn Ruth Alves. Christopher Rose. Aiden Xander Ullery. Bailey Marina Nobly. Timothy Donovan Johnson. Kristen Elizabeth Schott. Jennifer Ann Edney. Dylan Gore White. Peter William Murphy. Andrew Christopher Berardi. Cooper James McIntyre. Kevin Cornelius Wright. Benton Corb Caldwell. Lachlan Lee Farber. Grayson Charles Farber. Chase Philip Lemieux. Colton Evan Higgins. Olivia Ann Connors Gale. Saturn Du Bois. Francis Joseph Murphy. Samuel Freeman Weiner. Allison Jordan Diana. Suzanne Whitman Burns. Liana Marie Kiska. Sophia Andrea Baerga. Marissa Allison Wright. Madeline Lindsay Stallsmith. Helen Maud Carrier. Emma Grace Taylor. Jacob Dylan Packard. Dashiell Blue Parlante. Daniel Peyton Turner. Natalie Grace Ruffy. Daniel Anthony Forsyth. Roman Peter Gorman. Abigail Rose Allard. Sadie Evangeline Trudell. Julia Rose Morris. Natasha Marie Garcia Braley. Rowan Kelly Meager. Darby Carol Victor. Andrew Jermaine Carter. Annabelle Marie Quinn. Benny Rose Powers. Veda Jane Smith. Kevin Jones. Ashley McIntosh. Oriana Lamani Porter. Kaylia Kroll. Marta Vincent Brent. Susana Camille Joanna Ali. Julissa Alyssa Wilson. Rojean Brianna Waite. Danessa Latasha Luster. And the president of the class of 2023, Sophia Rhodes Easley.
Okay, at this time, the class of 2023 can rise. You might want to take off your tassels, and we'll give you a minute for that. While we're doing that, I'd like to thank everyone with the combs. Nice touch. The good Lord provided me with a certain hairstyle, and that was a nice touch. Thank you for the combs. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class, Nauset Regional High School, 2023. Our recessional hymn is Millennium by Richard Meyer, performed by the Nauset Regional High School Band and Orchestra, directed by Dan Anthony.
Thank you.